one in, and we are about ready to go. Puck is trying as soon as possible.
Go, 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 boys.
The Stars carry it along the wall.
James, the goalie's just going to drop into the butterfly, try and play the percentages and hope the puck hits him. He can't see it. There's so much traffic in front of the net. He doesn't find it, it doesn't hit him, and it's in the goal.
Edmonton's won the draw in the neutral zone. And he sides the puck with the kid. Takes the return feed.
Coming up. More than half the frame has been played here. The Oilers lead it 1-0. And they take possession. Nice job. The whistle icing the call. Some last second communication with the D as centers get ready to drop the puck. Huberdeau's won it in their own end.
Time. After the icing, there's a little more pressure on the centerman to win the draw.
Stop, it's just the puck sails over the glass.
positioning. Once he makes that first save, he's got to be in position to make the second. Well done.
Lots of time left in this period. The Oilers lead this 1-2-0. From off the wall, comes up with it with both centers scrummed up.
To get control of the puck first. So we'll look at the faceoff, and this power play has to generate a little momentum to get the first crack at it tonight.
Goes out of play. Dean's ready for the draw as they continue to be shorthanded here. Expired. We got a tie game. And momentum on their side as they win the draw inside the offensive zone. Oh, I had the right idea, but couldn't make that play. The Oilers have against the wall. Through pass ahead. Here's a quick pass.
She fell actually there, James, earlier in the shift, but she's not headed to the floor. She's going to try and finish this one out.
Explosion! Looking for that glitcher, eh, bud?
call. Officials getting ready to drop the puck to get play back underway. Here's a chance! And some friendly geometry comes in by the helm.
Well, it's not like you're trying to get it that close, but you get the bounce. You take it. That's kind of nice, isn't it? Taking advantage of that icing call, they win the draw. The shooter's in perfect position, and that puck is coming off his stick in a hurry.
Dallas has the one-goal lead here late in the second period, coming at a perfect time as we approach the intermission.
Great time to take the lead. Now you want to make sure that you're diligent and you're efficient in your play, that you have this lead when you go to the break.
And they are ready to drop the puck on period number three. All right, the puck is dropped on the third power play. Ray Ferraro is between both benches, ready to be made for the first two periods tonight. Edmonton's had such a meager total of shots on goal.
They've got to get more pucks to the net. He's just trying to get through the rest of this shift and get back to the bench.
Something happened. Textbook coach check by Huberto. And it's a quick pass to Foligno. Gets the full use of the stick.
Goal.
Plenty of playing time left in this frame. The Oilers are looking to build on this one goal lead. And with the centers tied up, he swoops in to take possession.
Hey, Feeney.
Its way through him. It looked like he had stopped it, but it rolled.
Dallas has evened things up and has certainly created a thought process, I would think, on both benches about the possibility of overtime.
No way to avoid it now. It's high, it's late, and nobody wants to make a mistake.
Lay it up!
Capitalize on this power play. Here comes the face-off. And as the puck is dropped, he will drop another inside the defensive zone. Gets it out of his own hand. Angles it over to Carrier. A critical draw here. Freeman's won the draw here in the ball.
Those face-off calculations are important. Now you've got the puck to go. It's going to be a penalty. They're going to have to pull back.
There's the whistle. Let's get the call from the officials.
To happen here. The penalty killers are going to get out here and try and do their best to keep the score the same.